Shall we have a short word of prayer? We are thankful to you, Lord. You are our great and good God, our merciful God. And Father God, thank you for the word of God has been read this evening. And your word is mighty and powerful. And your word is very potential enough to bless us. And so, Father God, this evening, as we look into your word, Holy Spirit, teach us very, very important lessons from the word of God. Open up the deep revelations and the treasures of your word unto us. And Father God, we want to hear the still small voice of the Holy Spirit speaking to us, that we can grow in our faith and we can walk with God in our life. Thank you, Father God. We commit this time into your hands. We ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. So this evening we are going to focus on faith is doing what God's word says. Faith is acting on the word of God or doing according to the directions of God's word or what God says or according to the guidance received from the Lord. And we will read Romans 10 verse 17. Romans 10, 17. So faith is doing what God's word says. Romans 10, 17. So faith comes from hearing, and hearing through the word of Christ. You see, the faith comes by hearing, and hearing what? Listening to Jesus. See, faith comes by listening to Jesus. After hearing what Jesus says, you have to do what the Lord says to you. After listening to what Jesus has said to you, you got to do what the Lord says to you. Now, many people pray prayers. They pray about their difficulties, their struggles, their pain, their sickness and diseases. And they pray about many things to Jesus. But you don't wait, or you don't take time to listen to Jesus, you see. People pray. People pray for many things. But then they don't wait to listen what Jesus has to say to them about their situation. See, that is the trouble and that is the problem. The Bible says in Hebrews chapter 11 and verse 6, you see. Hebrews 11 verse 6. And without faith, it is impossible to please him, you see. Without faith, you cannot please God. You cannot please Jesus. Without faith, it is impossible to please Jesus. For whoever draws near to God must believe that he exists, and he rewards those who seek him. You have to seek him. If you seek Jesus, then only you will be rewarded by getting the answer to your prayer. See, faith requires listening to Lord Jesus. And how can you listen to Lord Jesus? You have to take time to listen to Jesus. You have to seek him, you see. Without seeking Jesus, without taking time to listen to him, you are not going to get the answer for your prayers. You see, you have to listen what Jesus has to tell you. And then you have to do what he says. And so if you don't take time to listen to God's answer, how to resolve your situation, then your situation continues and even becomes worse, and you are wondering that I prayed for this situation, but the things are not changing. Why things are not changing? Because you are not seeking to listen to what Jesus has to say. You keep talking, but then a point comes, you got to be quiet. You have got to be silent and allow the Holy Spirit to speak to you. You have to allow the word of God to speak to you. You have to allow Jesus to speak to you and give you the direction about what you are supposed to do. And that is what we see in this passage, isn't it? We read in Luke chapter 5 verse 1. Luke 5 1. On one occasion, while the crowd was pressing in on him to hear the word of God. What was the crowd doing? The crowd was pressing upon Jesus to hear the word of God. You see, this is very important. You got to press on, you see. We should press on to Jesus to hear the word of God, to hear his voice. See, even today, as I am bringing you this message, and as you are hearing me speaking God's word, during this time, if you are listening very attentively, with a hungry heart, to listen to the voice of Jesus, then you will hear the voice of Jesus during this message. Maybe in the whole message, even one phrase can speak to you. Even Jesus can speak to you through one sentence or few words or even just one word that can impress upon your heart and upon your mind, and automatically you will say, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, you have spoken to me. See, you have to be very hungry and seeking to listen to the voice of Jesus. And we read from verse 4 to 9. Luke 5, 4 to 9. And when he had finished speaking, when Jesus had finished, completed talking with the crowd, see, now he personally speaks to Simon Peter. See, you have to allow Jesus to personally speak to you. What is faith? Faith is listening to what Jesus has to tell you personally and then doing it. And then you will be rewarded. And here we see Jesus said to Simon, put out into the deep and let your nets for a catch. And Simon answered, Master. See, Simon is saying, he's describing his troubles, his problems. He says, Master, we toiled all night and took nothing. We could not catch anything. But at your word, I will let down the nets. This is the important part. But Jesus, when you are saying something to me, I am listening. And now I'm going to do what you tell me. What you are saying to me. I will do what you say. I will take the boats, go down into the sea and let down the nets. And verse 6 says, and when they had done this, what did they do? They did what Jesus told them. They did what Jesus said to Peter. Simon, put out into the deep, go into the deeper part of the sea and let down your nets for a catch. And Peter said, at your word, Jesus, as you have said to me, I'm going to do it. And when they had done this, the Bible says they caught a large number of fish. You see, the problem was they had toiled all night. No fish, no catch, no success. Now Jesus says, do this. And he listened to what Jesus had to say. And then when he did it, this was practicing faith, you see. This is acting on your faith. He did it. And what happened? The Bible says they caught a large number of fish, you see. It was a big miracle. And the nets were breaking. They signaled to their partners in other boat to come and help them. And they came and filled both the boats so that they began to sink. See, there was no catch. But listening to what Jesus had to say and doing what Jesus said brought a big catch. It was such a huge catch that even their nets were breaking and even the two boats were about to sink. And verse 8, when Simon Peter saw it, he fell down at Jesus' knees, saying, "Depart from me, for I am a sinful man, O Lord." For he and all who were with him, for Peter and all that were with him, all his friends, his brothers, were astonished at the catch of fish they had taken. Do you want to be astonished by what God can do in your life? Do you want to be astonished by the miracle of God, our great answer of God? Then it is not enough only to pray. You got to take time to listen to Jesus. That is faith. If by faith you listen to Jesus, and when Jesus tells you to do something, do it. And you will be amazed when you do it. It will be a huge miracle. You will be rewarded greatly. Because the Bible says in Hebrews 11:6, without faith it is impossible to please God. Please God. Let's read from verses 18 to 26. Luke 5, 18 to 26. And behold, some men were bringing on a bed a man who was paralyzed. See, four friends or some men, they brought a paralytic man. The man was paralyzed on his both sides. You see, right and left, he was paralyzed. He cannot get up. He cannot lift his hand. He cannot walk. He was bedridden. That's what Bible says. And his friends were bringing him to Jesus. And then what happened? And they were seeking to bring him in and lay him before Jesus, but finding no way to bring him in because of the crowd. You see, there is difficulty. You see, to seeking Jesus is not an easy thing. But by faith you have to seek Jesus. There will be struggle to seek and find Jesus. But do it with all your heart. And you will be able to listen to what Jesus has to say. So they went up on the roof. They did not give up, you see. These people were not discouraged by the hurdles, you see, that were on their way of bringing that friend, their paralytic friend, to Jesus. What they did, they tried even more their best. They went up on the roof, let him down with his bed, threw the tiles into the midst before Jesus. They somehow came to Jesus. That's it. When they came to Jesus, they are going to listen to Jesus. Now this paralytic man will be able to listen to Jesus, and will be able to do what Jesus tells him. And when he does what Jesus tells him, he will get his big healing, big miracle, you see. And verse 20, and when Jesus saw their faith, he said, "Man, your sins are forgiven." You see, Jesus said to him, "Man, your sins are forgiven." You see, Jesus took care of the problem right in the beginning, you see. Because the Bible says, you see, all the suffering came into the human life because of man's sin. In Genesis chapter 3, when Adam and Eve committed sin, from that very day, from that very moment, the suffering came in the human life. And so in order to remove the suffering of this paralytic man, Jesus, the very first thing, told him, "Man, your sins are forgiven." And the man accepted it. But then there were other people who did not accept it. You see, there were scribes and Pharisees in verse 21 began to question, saying, "Who is this? Who speaks blasphemies? Who can forgive sins but God alone?" When Jesus perceived their thoughts, you see, they had not spoken audibly. They had not spoken from their mouth. They were just thinking thoughts in their mind, the scribes and Pharisees. But Jesus is the Creator God. So he knew their thoughts. So he tells them, "Why do you question in your hearts which is easier, to say your sins are forgiven you or to say rise and walk?" Verse 24. "But that you may know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins." See, the Lord Jesus Christ has authority to forgive sins. Why? Because he came as the Lamb of God to die for our sins and to shed his blood on the cross of Calvary. He became the Lamb of God that was sacrificed for our sins. And so Jesus has all authority to forgive all sins. And then he said to the man who was paralyzed, "I say to you, rise, pick up your bed and go home." Now the second thing that Jesus told this paralytic man is, rise up, pick up your bed and go home. And immediately the Bible says in verse 25, he rose up before them. See, this man, when he listened to Jesus, he did what Jesus told him to do, isn't it? He obeyed. Jesus said, "Rise up, pick up your bed on which you are lying and go home." And the man, Bible says, got up, took his bed, and as everybody was looking at him, he walked out. The paralytic man was healed. Because what did he do? He listened to Jesus. And secondly, he did what Jesus told him to do. And the third thing, he received his miracle. You see, this is faith. Many people do not know what is faith. And so today the Lord is teaching us what is faith. You see, got to learn it today. You can see extraordinary things only if you take time to listen to Jesus. And after you have taken time to listen to Jesus, and Jesus was able to speak to you and tell you to do certain things, and if you go out and do it, wow, then as Jesus has said, you do it exactly and you receive your miracle. You get your miracle, you see. This is faith. Let's go to verses 27 and 28. Luke 5, 27 and 28. After this, Jesus went out and saw a tax collector named Levi. You see, Jesus went out after all these things. He left that house and then he's walking on the streets. And I believe the disciples are walking with him. And the crowd is following him. And he comes to a place where a man called Levi was sitting in his tax collector office. You see, he was in his office. And he is a tax collector, collecting tax, sitting at the tax. That is what Bible says, sitting at the tax office. He was sitting at the tax office or tax booth. And Jesus said to him, "Follow me." Jesus spoke to this man called Levi, "Follow me." This man called Levi is none other but the man called Matthew. He's the same man of God called Matthew who wrote the Gospel of Matthew, actually. And Jesus said to this man who was a big tax collecting officer sitting in his tax office, And Jesus said to him, follow me. And leaving everything, he rose and followed him. And then rest is the history. How God used Matthew, you see, tremendously. And how God used him to write the book of the Gospel of Matthew. You see, same thing happened to me one day. Number of years back, while I was working as a computer programmer in my computer department in the company where they had newly started the computer work in their company. And I was the only man in those days they could find to run their computers. And I was all alone sitting in an air-conditioned office, you see. And Jesus told me, follow me, follow me. This Levi, he just got up and followed Jesus. I think I was not so obedient like that in those days. I argued with Jesus number of things. That who will take care of me, who will feed me, this and that, everything. But then finally I obeyed. I left everything. Let me tell you, to follow Jesus, I left everything. I left my father, my mother. I left my house, my home. I left everything. My mother cried so much. My grandmother cried so much. But I left everything and followed Jesus. And after so many years of following, I'm still following Jesus and being used by Jesus. See, you got to listen to Jesus and do what Jesus tells you. And the rest is the history. Rest is a mighty miracle of God, you see. Sometimes when you listen to Jesus, you will come to certain things that is beyond human logic. See, when we listen to the word of God, listen to Jesus, it will be beyond human mind. You will not be able to understand it at times. It will be beyond human logic. You might think this is a wrong thing. If you think according to your human intelligence, you might think this is wrong. This I am not able to understand. Certain things that Jesus tells you to do are beyond human logic. Even then, you got to listen to it and you got to do it, and that is faith. And that is faith, you see. Many times you may hear God telling you that defies human logic and human mind. But even then, if you do it, you will see a miracle. You will see a miracle. Let us go to Matthew 17, 24 to 27. Matthew 17, 24 to 27. When they came to Capernaum, the tax collectors, you see, again we come to tax collectors. The collectors of 2 drachma tax went up to Peter and said, does your teacher not pay the tax? Does not your teacher pay the tax? And Peter replied, he said, yes. Peter said, yes. Jesus also pays tax, you see. And when he came into the house, when Peter came into the house, Jesus spoke to him first saying, you see, Peter had this conversation outside on the street with the tax collectors. But Jesus was not with him at that time. Jesus was in the house. But as I told you, Jesus is God. He will know everything you talked even on the street or what happened with you. He knows everything. See, that's the amazing part. Our Lord Jesus, the creator of the heaven and earth, knows everything that happens with you. Don't think he doesn't know. But the thing is, we got to take time to listen to Jesus. You got to take time to listen to Jesus. Now it is time for Peter to listen to Jesus. Jesus spoke to Peter first saying, "What do you think, Simon? From whom do kings of the earth take toll or tax? From their sons or from others?" And when he said from others, Jesus said to him, that is Peter, "Then the sons are free." The sons are free. They don't have to pay tax. "However, not to give offense to them, go to the sea and cast a hook." They use the hook even in those days. See that. "And cast a hook and take the first fish that comes up. And when you open its mouth, you will find a shekel." You will find a coin which is very valuable. It's a shekel actually. See, Peter was an expert fisherman. He had been fishing all his life. And he had caught thousands and thousands and thousands upon fishes in his life. And he had never seen a single fish with a shekel or a coin in its mouth. See, this was beyond human intelligence. This was beyond human logic. Arre, this cannot happen like this. Aise kaise ho sakta hai? You know, we talk like that. Aise kaise ho sakta hai? How can this happen, you see? I am an expert fisherman. I have caught thousands and thousands of fishes. Not a single fish from its mouth gave me a coin, you see. And Jesus is saying, go to the sea. Drop the hook. Catch the first fish. Open its mouth and you will get a shekel. See, there are times when Jesus tells us some things that are beyond human intelligence, beyond human mind, and beyond human logic, but still do not argue with Jesus. Because he is the creator of the heaven and the earth. He is the Almighty God. Look, listen to Jesus, and do what Jesus says. And the Bible says Peter went. Peter went, and he dropped the hook in the sea, caught the fish. The first fish he caught, he opened the mouth and he found a shekel, you see. Now one shekel means 2 drachmas. Those people, the tax collectors, were asking to pay 2 drachmas. 1 drachma for Peter and 1 drachma for Jesus. And 1 shekel equals to 2 drachmas. And so Jesus said, you will get a shekel. Get that one coin, valuable coin, gold coin, shekel, and pay the tax for me and Peter for you. And see that. Peter went and did it. He got a fish with a shekel in its mouth and paid the tax for Jesus and for himself. But what Jesus told him was beyond human logic. Let's go to the second thing in the Bible, second illustration. You know, let me give you an example from my own life, you see. You have heard this many, many times from my mouth. You know, Gujarat had a very severe earthquake, terrible earthquake in 2001, you see. Terrible earthquake. More than 2.5 lakhs people died, you see. It is like 25 million actually. 2.5 lakhs of people, no, it's not 25 million. It's less than even half the million. 250,000 people died. 250,000 people died. And so 2.5 lakhs of people died. It was a terrible killer earthquake. And people were running to the north of Gujarat to help people and to help those who were suffering and to help the victims. And at that time I was pastoring a church, and then every afternoon I used to spend time listening to Jesus, praying and then listening to Jesus. And so my prayer was, this big earthquake, Lord, has come. Many organizations and many people are going north to help people. But Lord Jesus, what do you want me to do? What do you want me to do? And as I was praying and listening to Jesus, keeping quiet, I heard one word, Runard. I heard one word, Runard. I used to keep a pen with me. So I suddenly wrote it down, what I heard, Runard. At that time, I could not even speak properly this word. It was a tongue twister. But then I heard the word Runard, and I felt Lord Jesus is telling me to go to a place called Runard. But I never heard about it. And I don't know in which direction it is and where to go. I don't know anything. So then the Sunday came. I took this word Runard to my church. And as I was doing the church worship service, I told the people, this is what I heard from Lord Jesus. I heard this word Runard, and I don't know what does it mean. And it looks like Jesus is telling me to go to that place called Runard. So have you people heard about this word? Silence. Nobody had heard this word ever in their life, Runard. But one brother in our church took a pen and wrote it down in his Bible or on a piece of paper, this word called Runard. And then next day he went to his company that was south from the city where I was pastoring, that was called Baroda. The earthquake had happened in the north, in the north of Gujarat, even northern than Ahmedabad. And I was in Baroda, and this brother used to work some in another district. Baroda also has a Baroda district, and then there is a Bharuch district. And he used to work in a company in Bharuch, and every day he used to go there. And so he took this word to his company. And then there are so many workers in his company. And so he began asking people, have you heard this? Have you heard this word? Have you heard this word? Have you heard this word? Everybody said, no. No, we haven't heard this word. We haven't heard this word. Then one man said, yes, I have heard this word, Runard. It is the name of a village. And this village is in the more south from here. There is a village called Runard. No proper road goes to this village. It is south from here, and no proper road goes there. So he brought this information to me and said, Pastor, there is a village called Runard, but it is in the south of Gujarat. I said, wow. Then I prayed again, and I was wondering, Jesus, I was praying that I want to help the earthquake victims and earthquake suffering people. And earthquake happened in the north. And you told me, Runard. Did I listen correctly? Did I listen correctly? But Jesus did not answer me. So I had a question, but what is faith? Faith is listening to Jesus and doing what Jesus says. And so somehow I must go to that village then. And then I had some friends, they were from South India, and they had a Maruti car. In those days, I had only scooter, you see. I had a two-wheeler. I did not have car or anything, you see. And those friends, they came to know about this. One of them was coming to my church, actually. So they said, "Let's go, Pastor. We will go in my car. Let us go and find out this place." So someone gave us the information that if you go to Jambusar, maybe from Jambusar someone can guide you. So we went to a church in Jambusar. We talked to the pastor, and the pastor brought a man from his church and said, "This man knows the way to go to Runad." And he said, "But there is no proper way. You might have to drive through all the dirt and all the mud and even through the farms and fields." But these two brothers were excited. Jesus has spoken. And so we said, "Let us go then." We took that brother. He kept on showing us the way. Turn right, turn left, and go straight. And we went. In those days, there was no GPS, okay? And we went all the way to that village. And before we enter the village, there is a small hill. And the car climbed the hill and stopped on the top. And what can we see? What can we see? We came out of the car. I started crying. All the homes and houses in that village had flattened, had fallen down. For many, many days, people had no water, no food, no help, because the outside world did not know what had happened to this village, you see. Somehow the earthquake came in the north, but we do not know that any aftershock or some earthquake tremor passed through this village and flattened it down. Only God knew the condition of these people. And because I took time to listen to Jesus, and he gave me the word Runad, and I obeyed and I went. And the rest is the history. Many people got saved in that place. Many homes were repaired and constructed back. I never saw a single dollar in my hand. But God brought his people, God brought his men, and helped those people financially, materially, to repair their homes. My job was only to preach. I used to go and preach. Jesus looked at you from heaven. Give your lives to Jesus. And those Hindu people gave their lives to Jesus. My dear friends, you got to hear what Jesus has to say. Let me go to Exodus 14, 13 to 18. Exodus chapter 14, 13 to 18. What did I say? Faith is listening to God and doing what he says. Faith is listening to Jesus and doing what he tells you. Exodus 14, 13 to 18. See, what Jesus tells is sometimes beyond human logic. Does not look right to the human mind. But still, you got to obey it and do it, and you will see a mighty miracle. And Moses said to the people, see, the people had escaped from Egypt and they were traveling to go into the promised land. But as they were going, they came to a place where it was a Red Sea that came in their path. It was a sea. Red Sea is a Red Sea even today, okay? If you go on the world map, you can see it. The Red Sea is a big sea. And they came to the Red Sea and see what happened. Then Pharaoh and his army began chasing them, pursuing them with great anger, and he wanted to kill all the Israelites, and he was coming down with his army. And Moses said to the people, "Fear not, stand firm and see the salvation of the Lord, which he will work for you today. For the Egyptians whom you see today, you will never see again. The Lord will fight for you, and you have only to be silent." And then see what God says is beyond human logic. What he tells them to do is beyond human logic. The Lord said to Moses, "Why do you cry to me?" People were afraid and crying. "Why do you cry to me? Tell the people of Israel to go forward." See, the Lord is saying, keep marching on, go forward. Where can you go forward? There was a big Red Sea. There was a big Red Sea and lots and tons of water, and there was no way. There was no path. There was nothing. But God says, go forward, go ahead. But there was no way and no path. Just beyond human logic, right? And then verse 16, lift up your staff and stretch out your hand over the sea and divide it, that the people of Israel may go through the sea. Go through the sea on dry ground. See, what God says, what Jesus says, is beyond human logic. He has to only lift up his stick and just lift it up towards the sea like this. Just like this. And Moses obeyed. Moses did what Jesus said. He just lifted up his staff, and the sea began to divide and began to part. The sea was parting, and they walked on the dry ground. Where there was no way, God made a way. Where there was no path, God made a path. You know, many people send a prayer request, like people suffering from cancers and diseases that are incurable. But my dear friend, where there is no path, where there is no medicine, Jesus can make a path. Jesus can heal you. Jesus can cure you. You got to take time to listen to Jesus. And Jesus will tell you how it can be done. How you can come out of that situation. How you can be healed. And Jesus can make a way where there is no way. It takes faith. What is faith? Faith is listening to Jesus and doing what he says. Yes, the sea divided. People of Israel escaped through the way that God made, through the sea on the dry ground. When the Egyptians tried to follow them, what happened? They were drowned, you see. They were drowned. They had not listened to the word of God. See, people who tried to do something that they had never heard from God, they failed. Who succeeded? People who had heard from Jesus and did what Jesus said, they succeeded. But others who had not listened to Jesus, they failed. And we read, and so today prayer and listening to Lord Jesus is very important. And then doing what Lord Jesus says is faith. We read in 2 Corinthians 5:7. 2 Corinthians 5:7. For we walk by faith and not by sight. See, we as believers are called to walk by faith and not by what we see. Not by sight. Walk by faith and not by sight. See, the people of the world say that what I see, I believe. Only what I can see through my eyes are what the things which I can touch, the things which I can hear about, then only I will believe. If I do not see anything, I do not believe. Bible faith says, first believing, then seeing. First, you got to believe what Jesus tells you to do and do it, and then you will see it, you see. Then you will see it. Faith is first believing what I do not see and then doing what Jesus tells you to do, and then you will see the miracle. And that's why Bible says, Hebrews chapter 11 verse 1. Hebrews 11:1. Now faith is the substance of the things hoped for. And secondly, faith is the evidence of things not seen. See, faith is the evidence of things not seen. And that's why Bible says, faith is first believing what I do not see. The world will mock you, insult you, because the theory of the world is human logic. They will tell you, only if I see, then only I will believe. Bible says, first you believe what Jesus told you, what Jesus has said to you, believe it and do it, then you will see it. See, faith is the evidence of things not seen. And so, no human logic works when it comes to faith. And the Bible says, without faith, you cannot please God. Hebrews 11:6. Without faith, you cannot please God. You know, many, many have become Christians. And even believers, but I do not know whether they have faith. My dear friends, if you have faith, you will take time to listen to Jesus. And when you listen to Jesus, do what Jesus says, and there will come a solution and a miracle for your situation. There will come answers to your prayers. Mighty things God will be able to do for you. God bless you. Let us pray. Let us close our eyes and pray in your heart. Lord, thank you for teaching me today what is faith. Faith is not only praying. Yes, praying and then taking time to listen to the voice of Jesus, to listen to what Jesus has to say about that problem and how it can be solved. Listening to Jesus and then doing what Jesus tells you to do. And you will be rewarded by a mighty miracle from our Lord Jesus. Many times we fail in listening to Jesus. And many times, even if you have listened to Jesus, you fail in doing it and obeying it. The result is you never get your miracle. The result is your child never gets healed. The result is you continue to suffer and your family suffers. My dear friend, Bible declares, Hebrews 11:6, Without faith, it is impossible to please God. And so pray in your heart. Thank you, Lord, what you have taught me today. Lord, help me to take time to pray. Help me to take time to listen to Jesus. And help me to do what Jesus tells me to do, so that I can get my miracle, so that I can see the Holy Spirit release His mighty power and change the conditions and situations and circumstances. If you pray this prayer, the Lord will help you to grow in faith, and He'll make you hungry and more thirsty to hear the word of God, to listen what God has to say, to listen what the Holy Spirit has to say, to listen what Jesus has to say, and the Lord will give you grace to do what He tells you to do. Thank you, mighty Father God, our Lord Jesus. Thank you for teaching us a very, very important and a valuable lesson about faith this evening. If we practice this Bible-taught faith, then Lord, our life will be transformed, and God will be able to use us mightily. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Continue to bless your people, Lord. We ask in Jesus' name. Amen.